What's up, Mono Brothers? It's Pirzagwadi, and welcome to a brand new series called What If Naruto's 3 years were different? If you don't understand by the theme of the title, then I'll tell you guys what I mean by it. So, during the 3 years time skip after the Sasuke retrieval arc for the first time, between Sasuke retrieval arc and the start of Shippuden, you know, the 3 year time skip. Yeah, so Naruto goes outside the village with Jiraiya to train, but all he learned was how to make big Rasengans and control only till the three tails. In my opinion, Naruto could have been stronger than the cannon, but he didn't. When Sasuke went to train with Orochimaru, he gets an S-class jutsu and his power skyrockets. Even Sakura, a trash and a useless character, got exponentially strong with the help of Tsunade. Even if she did become useful, she was still trash. That was development, but that was development. But Naruto had the least bit of power up in the whole canon. His biggest power ups were Rasen Shuriken, Sage Mode, mastering the Kyuubi Chakra, etc. All he learned from Jiraiya was how to make big ass Rasengans. That's it in terms of jutsu. So I had an idea. Instead of Naruto learning some big ass Rasengans and how to control his Kyuubi Chakra, but just a little, what if he got more? What if Naruto's 3 years were different? So without any further ado, let's get watching. So a couple of days after Naruto left the village, Jiraiya had a thought. What if he couldn't save Naruto from the Akatsuki? The Akatsuki is comprised of rogue S-rank ninjas, and among them is Itachi, who killed the entire Uchiha clan by himself. Jiraiya knows that he can defeat at least one or two at most, but what if they all jumped at him at the same time? Jiraiya couldn't protect Naruto, and Naruto would be killed, and the Kyuubi would be stolen. So Jiraiya decides to bring Naruto to that place. He uses some hand seals to reverse summons him and Naruto back to Mount Myoboku, the mountain of the toads. Naruto questions Jiraiya's intention, but Jiraiya simply states that this place is much better than traveling through the entire world. Naruto is excited at the prospect of him training with the toads, since he knows how strong Gama Bunta is. Jiraiya takes Naruto to the Toad Elder and explains the situation to him. The Toad Elder, knowing Naruto is a child of prophecy, lets Naruto stay and train here. Jiraiya tells Naruto about this spider network crap and how he tells he would come back. And before Naruto could tell anything, Jiraiya disappears. Naruto curses for being alone, but Gama Genji bumps into him and they talk a bit. And Gama Bunta comes into him, also they talk a bit. Under the power, Toad comes and takes Naruto to his 3 year team skimming. 3 year training. So I'm going to divide the years into first year, second year, and third year. I'm going to tell you what happened in each of the current years. So anyways, the first year of training, the Power Toad decides to check Naruto's affinity. And to his surprise, Naruto's chakra nature is wind, lightning, and water, which are the main jutsus of the Toad. In the first year, Naruto learns many wind style, lightning style, and water style jutsus. Naruto tries to replicate Kakashi's Chidori and Raikiri, but due to Naruto's bad memory and his stupidity, he couldn't replicate it. Naruto reminds himself to ask Kakashi about the two jutsus. During the training with Shadow Clones, Naruto accidentally bumps into the special ability of the Shadow Clones, which is the mental experience after the clone is dispelled. Due to Naruto having a huge amount of chakra and can make thousands of Shadow Clones, he abuses the special trait to its limit. During training, Jiraiya comes back and to teach Naruto about the Rasengan, and to his surprise, Naruto is abusing his shadow clones to help him attain near mastery of Jiraiya in less than a year of Rasengan. He can make 100 Rasengan, but he still needs his shadow clone to make the big ball Rasengan. Due to abusing the shadow clones for nearly a year, his chakra level skyrocketed and he has learned many jutsus. His chakra control also skyrocketed. At the end of the year, Naruto fixes on his taijutsu on the second year of training. The Toad Elder decides to teach Naruto the Sage Mode and tells Part Toad about it. Pardo accepts it and starts teaching Naruto about the basics of the Sage Mode. It takes days to Naruto to understand and he starts training. When the Pardo sits on Naruto's shoulders to help him gather energy, the Kyubi kicks the Toad Sage out of the Naruto's shoulder. Naruto, hearing about this, is mad and decides to have the talk with the Kyubi once and for all. He decides Pardo how to talk, and Pardo just tells him to concentrate on the seal in his stomach. Due to Naruto's intense training in the past year, he has gotten a lot, I mean a lot smarter, and he's able to enter the mindscape after just a few minutes. There he meets and he and the Kyubi have a talk about the training. Naruto shouts at the Kyubi and the Kyubi is also shouting at Naruto. They both are having a verbal argument, and by the end of it, the Kyubi just tells Naruto that he won't disrupt his chakra control. Naruto smiles and thanks the Kyubi, which takes the Kyubi by shock. Before Kyubi could say anything, Naruto comes back to the real world and tells a story to the Pardo. Naruto starts containing nature energy, but this becomes way more easier. At the training of the day, Naruto practices jutsu and starts improving his Rasengan into perfection, which is to combine the elemental chakra into his Rasengan. This takes a couple of days, but he's able to do so. The wind style Rasengan and Rasen Shuriken is born. But this just takes a whole huge toll on Naruto's chakra as well as his body. Naruto, after a couple of days, is able to attain the Sage Mode, but Pardo tells Naruto to completely master the Sage Mode, which he does. It takes months, but Naruto is able to completely master Sage Mode without the use of Shadow Clones. After a couple of days, he's able to master the Rasen Shuriken without any Shadow Clones by discovering that it is way easier to use a jutsu using nature energy. Naruto starts practicing to mix his lightning style with his Rasengan and actually discovers the vanishing Rasengan. He masters this jutsu in a matter of days and starts mastering the other jutsu so he could use it without doing hand skills, since he knows about the Sharingan's copy ability, because he has to face Sasuke in the future and bring him back. Anyways, at the end of the year, he masters all of his jutsu in his arsenal with the help of the Shadow Clones and with his own determination. He's able to use Big Ball Rasengan one-handedly now. After the arguments and fights with Kyubi, Naruto wanted to annoy him a little bit more, so he decided to meet him every day. This soon caused Naruto and the Kyubi to become friends. The Kyubi won't admit it, but he considers Naruto as a friend too. He even told Naruto his name, which is Kurama. No one knows that Naruto and Kurama talk to each other, since Kurama doesn't want to know about this yet. Third year of training. Naruto's third year started with his birthday, as he spent 2 years on Mount Myoboku. Jiraiya comes back after his year of researching and spying. When he heard Naruto did and the last time he saw him, Jiraiya decided this was the time that Naruto learned the truth about his past. While celebrating with his droids, Jiraiya pulls Naruto to the side and tells him everything he knows. Who his parents are, what they were like, and what the things they did. Naruto has the blank expression for some minutes, but then he becomes angry and starts shouting at Jiraiya. The Toads get what's going on after being informed by the Pardo. Naruto is super pissed that Kurama's chakra leaks out of him. But Kurama inside Naruto decides to talk and tell Naruto about their talk, which Kurama needs to talk to him. Naruto, hearing this, relaxes a little, but he's still angry at Jiraiya, the third Hokage, and the village. Naruto rushes up to the corner and talks to Kurama. Kurama tells him everything about him and what happened during Naruto's birth. Naruto listens carefully and can understand the situation fully, but that doesn't change the fact that his own dad made his life a living hell. It takes a while to calm Naruto down, but Kurama is able to do it with his own version of talking or jutsu. After Naruto calmed down, Kurama tells Naruto about the seal and its key, and Naruto decides that he is going to free Kurama. Naruto goes to the Chito and asks the key. The Chito just smiles and asks Pardo to summon the seal. Pardo hesitates at first, and Jiraiya left after telling Naruto the truth, but easily agrees, knowing Naruto's power of his house of his own. After Pardo summons the key, Naruto reads it and understands what to do. He uses the blood to extract the key and goes to the corner of the mountain so he wouldn't destroy anything accidentally. The toes all are ready to fight if something goes wrong. Naruto sits and closes his eyes, entering his mindscape. He sees Kurama looking at him curiously, and Naruto just smiles at Kurama and walks to towards the seal stuck in the cage. Naruto reaches and starts pulling the seal, but then a hand stops him from doing so. When Naruto sees who it is, he sees his father, Minato Namakaze. As soon as Naruto saw him, every cuss word in the dictionary in Naruto was spluttered out by Naruto. His anger skyrocketed and he started beating up Minato and started calling him a bad father, and Minato not doing anything in response because he know he deserved it. After a couple of minutes, Minato is in the ground bruised and bloody, and Naruto is just huffing after releasing all of that inner anger. But Naruto's hatred just goes after seeing his father get up and talk about the seal. Naruto just completely shuts him off by using the Sage Mode Rasen Shuriken on him. When it hit Minato, who was shocked to the core. A light envelops the surrounding, and an area comes out a beautiful woman with red hair. Her name was Kushina Uzumaki, and she's Naruto's mother. She starts talking about her past, but Naruto stops her on her tracks and asks her how they both got there. Since he doesn't want to deal with this right now. Kushina sighs, knowing whatever she tries, she can't make Naruto forgive them. So she tells the reason, and this angers Naruto even more. So he shouts at them for being very parents. How they were in seals waiting to come when the village was difficult, or if he needed to control the QB, but never to meet him or talk to him. Minato tries to argue, but Naruto just stops and dies in its tracks and saying that all of this family drama is bullshit. He was gonna go back to Kurama, but Minato appears in front of him and places his hand on Naruto. Naruto was gonna shoot his hand off of him, but he received something, a complete guide on how to use the flying Raijin and all of Minato's jutsus. Before Naruto could say anything, Minato apologizes and disappears. Naruto unconsciously tears up and starts crying. Kushina sees Naruto crying, hugs her, and to her surprise, he hugs her back. They stay this way for a couple of seconds, but Kushina breaks the hug and gives a hand on Naruto, transferring all of her sealing jutsus. She also disappears, saying sorry. Naruto starts full blood crying, and Kurama knows that Naruto needs it, so he lets them have it. After a couple of minutes of trying, Naruto picks up himself and thanks his parents. His dream has changed from becoming the Hokage to something else, but the important matter is now to release Kurama. Naruto puts his chakra on his fingers and uses the key to unlock the cage. The chakra passed outside the gate, subconsciously absorbed by Naruto, strengthening his body. Kurama comes out stretching his limbs and tails and smiles at Naruto. Naruto smiles back and talks about Naruto's experience. Naruto decides to go before Kurama stops him and stretches his paw into a ball of fist and stretches it in front of Naruto. Naruto, thinking that this is a fist bump, does so, but Kurama had another plans. After he comes out of the mindscape, he notices a huge amount of chakra surrounding him. The toads are on guard, now that Naruto has woken from his so-called sleep, but Naruto just stands there with this yellow coat surrounding him, his whole body surrounded with chakra. Naruto just smiles and mumbles, "Thanks, Kurama." So for the next of the year, Naruto masters his KCM2 state, flying Raijin expert. He starts exporting sealing jutsus, as well as the jutsus given by Kushina and Minato by abusing the Shadow Clone. After 3 years, Naruto says bye to the Toad of Mount Byobokus. During his 3 years, his life changed for the better as well as his summon. Gamakichi is super strong, and while just growing, Naruto resummons himself back to the place where he first resummoned himself. After reaching the place, Naruto starts tracking back to the village which made his childhood worse and which his parents died to protect, the village hidden in the leaves. And that's where I'm going to leave for this episode, guys. If you guys like this video, like, share, subscribe, do the necessary stuff, and if you don't, I can understand. So, peace out.